नमस्कार, आई एम मिस्टर बुद्धदेव चैटर्जी। आई हैव बीन कॉल्ड फॉर दिस सेशन, लाइव सेशन फ्रॉम नमस्कार, आई एम संगीता आचार्य बुद्धदेव चैटर्जी। आई हैव बीन कॉल इन्वाइटेड एंड कॉल फॉर दिस लाइव सेशन फ्रॉम क्लासिकल म्यूजिक, क्लासिकल म्यूजिक फैन क्लब फॉर ए लाइव डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन ऑन फ्लूट and obviously on classical music. So it is, I am very much glad and I feel pleasure to have such an invitation, to get such an invitation. And firstly, I will tell something. I had some different thought also in my subject, in my stream. Firstly, my introduction about myself. I am from Rampur Maihar Shainik Gharana. That is, I have been trained in flute by late Professor Devoprasad Banerjee, who was the disciple of Pandit Gaur Goswami and Panalal Ghosh, that is from Alauddin Khan, and which is the ultimate and the most starting point of flute as classical instrument, as a Darbari instrument, who have taken this instrument in the classical field. That is Pandit late Panalal Ghosh, the pioneer of Indian flute. I am from that gharana, parampara style. After that, for a long time, for near about 2.5 decades, 24 years or above, I was under the Titanic of a music who left the world last year. This June, month of June, will be his 1 year of demise. We will celebrate it. That is Pandit Shamresh Chaudhuri, the famous vocalist of all the times, who was from Ravi Shankar, Pandit Ravi Shankar style. Pandit, he was the most favorite student, disciple of Pandit Ravi Shankar, as you all know. So, a conglomeration or what I will say, it is a amalgamation of these two styles had enriched me, I think. Something to tell, it is about my CV or biodata, but I want to tell something about my subject, my instrument. Flute is an instrument, obviously, one of the oldest instrument ever in anywhere of the world, not in only in India, but in everywhere in the world. Flute is the oldest, one of the oldest instrument. In our Vedas, in our ancient scriptures, it is written that there was three instruments. One musical instruments, that is shur instrument. That is, the first is gatra vina, second is bina, and third is benu. Gatra vina means the bina which is inside our body. That is our vocal cord. Is the first instrument. The second instrument is the bina, which is outside, then made by some animal or wooden something products. And the last is bina and benu. This benu, next the name changed to murli, afterwards it changed to basuri, bashi in Bengali, bahi in Assamese. There are many names, but the thing is ultimately the same thing. What is this flute? In instrument, we divide instrument in three types. That is, one is vocal instrument, one is blowing instrument, second is bowing instrument, and third is percussion instruments, plucking string instruments. After that, percussion instruments come. It takes the role of the laya. It is different. It is not of my topics. The three types of instruments are there. Firstly is blowing instrument. In India, we call it in Hindi or in other language, shushir jantra, which is played through the breath. In the Western world, it is called, flute is called the blowing instrument, to blow. But I call it a bit different. I call it a breath instrument. A breath instrument. Shash jantra. Why? And what is the difference between shash jantra and blow? There is some very integrated, very subtle points here, and which must be noted. Very simple thing, that is to blow him out, somebody says, blow him out. Blow means the air, through the air you are blowing something out, and with there arises the matter of strokes and something, to stroke. But breath means what we call in our own colloquial words or in general words. Breath means this is a natural process. From where comes pranayam, pranayam. Pran ki aram ko hum log kehte hai pranayam. What does pranayam mean? I mean flute playing from my side. It is a rechak pranayam, not purak pranayam. Purak means inhalation and rechak means exhalation. It is a type of exhalation. It is just nothing. It is a type of only exhalation. Normal exhalation and an exhalation which is linked with the heart and mind focused totally on the depth of music, the eternity of music, the ecstasy of music. So, if I call it breath instrument and not call it as if blowing instrument, I think it will be preferable. It is a breath instrument. And every flute player must think about it, which is a bit scarce in nowadays. what I am telling you, you have to realize it. I will not depict the picture, but what we have been taught from the beginning of our life, from the Gharana Parampara, from Panalal Ghosh style, that flute has that mesmerizing, that soul effort, which comes from the nad, comes from here. And the nad is produced with the friction of the fire which is in our navi and pranavayu. There the nad arises, and through that nad, with the help of vocal cord, a person sings. And without their any help of vocal cord or something like that, the air is breath. The air, that air which has the element of prana, is coming through our mouth hole and being poured in the flute. And that flute is also a totally natural instrument. It has got no unnaturality. One of the single most instrument in the world which has got no unnaturality. The total instrument is made of a bamboo. Here it is bamboo, and we play bamboo flutes. And only in the above some things with some it is been closed, because the air can't pass from the upper side, and the air will go through this side. This is the vacuum of the air, and it regulates the shur. So this we must think about it, that it is a breath instrument. Breath is another language of life. Music is the reflection of life, we all know. It is our reflection of life, our culture. But our flute is directly not the reflection, it is the total focusing of your life force, your vital force, through music towards eternity, I think. If you want, through this blow with the music, to downwards, you can also take it. But you can also take it on the upwards, towards the marg, Gandharva marg. So it is my first point, I must tell it. There is a reason behind it, because I had been invited on another session as an audience by my friend, my very beloved friend Vivek Sonarji, just some hours before that. Tomorrow at 11:30 p.m. there will be a live session upon flute, and the coming persons are all icons. That is Pandit Hari Prasad Chaurasia, Pandit Nityanand Haldi Pureji, who is our milestone of this gharana now, from Karnataki music Tyagarajan ji, and also Vivek Sonar ji. There will be a discussion upon the flute evolution and the future of flute. I am nobody. I think I am a very little person, but I think about this matter. Not only I give my breath here and I play, but I think. Thinking is the projection of the mind, is the quality of a human being. A human being must think something. Now, I think that music must be in our flute. The coming future of the flute, I had to tell something which I will I can't share there. They will, the icons will tell their experiences and something like that. But I want to tell that as there are different sphere in different aspect, in different music also, in vocal music, there is light music, there is folk music, and also there is classical music. So flute playing must also be very much segregated in this styles. A classical flute player is rather different. He will play in different motions and in different way, and it will be through his gharana parampara. I think it, and I had the responsibility to tell this, and I had been invited here. A great audience is there. I want to express my heartfelt this feeling that a classical flute must have some not very much similar to other instruments and other stream of classical department. It will not be a mixture of light music and classical music. It must have that purity, and a person to produce that purity must have some talim, that is guru shishya parampara. Nextly, my another thing to tell, I had spoken about it, but more confirmly, as it is through, it is a figure of our pran vayu. A flute is a instrument which is controlled totally by our pran vayu. So it is the very basic point one must remember, and simultaneously the thing comes that it is very near to how a person sings. It must come because it is through our pranvayu. A plucking string instrument may be different in different styles, because he have to do his different work here. Tang, he had to stroke here. If he do not strokes, then there will be no sound. But in flute, all right, Devaprasad Banerjee, I will speak something about Devaprasad Banerjee also. A person who, playing flute, he must be very much near to the vocal music. Vocal music in different category. That is, when a person is performing a vocal music classically, khyal is a style, Drupad is a style, and a flute player must depict as if a vocal player is playing or singing a Drupad. Like this. Everything like this. It is my thinking, it is my philosophy, and I personally used to follow this principle always. So, a thing I will say, I don't want to hurt anybody. Some procedures which nowadays we are using very much, that is vibratos, stroke in flute, where this tongue is used very, very much. In our recitals, we youngsters, not only youngsters, my fellows and my friends, everybody is using that tongue and vibrato. This vibrato, that the sound is just trembling, trembling, trembling and trembling, never standing. Why never standing? when a person sings, every note had its own vibration. And not only we, only in Indian music, vibrato is totally unscientific, I think. Vibrato comes from the Western music, because there are only notes, but we all not only deal with the notes, we deal with the relation between the notes. And I am writing, I write something, I have a page also, you can follow me, Buddhadev Chatterjee. Now I am going to write, I am writing, it will be published some days after. It is a very tough topic, between the notes. This between the notes, from sa to re, re to ga to ma, this, or from sa to ma, there is a long way. And a long way before I sleep. And after that, I have a artist is, he's ended. When he knows all the relations between the notes, in Indian aspect. In Western aspect, it is rather different. It is the perspective is rather different. They harmonizes the notes, but we rather melodifies the note. And melody comes from the relation, and this relation is developed then onwards when we have got very integrated and very subtle thinking of love. From a note, from sa to re, when we are going, if we focus on ourselves, then we will have to focus in our brain. Jhaan ke dekhna padega, andar mein, andar ko dekhna hoga, bahar ko nahi. We all see the outward life, not the inside. And music lies, Indian classical music lies inside. The raga raginis are all there in our body. But we want a guru who will lit a fire and just put it inside our body. And the light will come up. Very shortly I have told, tomorrow we will listen what the great persons will tell about these things. And lastly, what I am, some of my guru bhais came, he requested me to tell about Debo Prasad Banerjee. He was my flute guru, from whom I had taken the ganda. He was a milestone of our modern Gayaki Ang flute playing. I bow to him with every respect. He has taught the world how to follow the fathers. That is Gaur Goswami, Pannalal Ghosh. He has taught, not only he, there are other guru bhais of him also. They are not now known, but we must I knew them because everybody loved me. I used to have good relation with everybody because I love everybody. I have got respect to everybody, every person. And I think that respect is the basic platform of life and music. If a person is disrespectful, he can't play any music, I think. And Nikhilesh Roy, many persons, Boyjantu Banerjee, there were many students there of the late Pannalal Ghosh and Gaur Goswami. And my Guru Debo Prasad Banerjee was the icon. Nextly, I must tell the person who had made me, that is Pandit Samaresh Chaudhuri. I feel that if I have not touched his his lotus feet, I can't play anything in my life. Everything what I play now is from him. I pay my every tribute to my guru, the Titanic, the dictionary of ragas, Pandit Samaresh Chowdhury. And today also I will explore the things, the ragas, according to his thought only, only from his thought, nothing from no more person's thought, from Samaresh Chowdhury. I will not speak anything from myself and from any other persons. I will speak of Samaresh Chowdhury. Now, what I am going to explore today, that is Kanra. This Kanra subject is very much less explored in flute. Why I don't know, but it is a very interesting thing. What is Kanra? Firstly, in our Indian music, we called Ang. There are two types of Ang. One, Ragang. Second, Kriyang. Firstly, if I call Kriyang, Kriyang is the improvisation of the artist upon a specific raga, upon a specific raga by a group of artists or a single artist through a maestro, Kriyang. And that Ragang is that exceeding two notes, that is above two notes, using above two notes, if we use above two notes with which there creates a temperament, bhav or rush. This rush, navrush, there is in our language, in our musical and philosophical scriptures, it is all written. I'm not going to aid. This, when above two notes, using three or four notes, we produce some special atmosphere we can create, then it is Ragang. This Ragang, according to my Guru Pandit Samaresh Chowdhury, started very from the ancient times, started with Sarang, because it is very much linked with our daily life. Sarang, the first Ragang, came from the sunlight, because sun is our god, Surya Narayan. From that Sarang came Malhar, Malhar Ang, Ragang, that is which clears the air of the world, the wastage of the world through water, watery element, Malhar. Thirdly, from Malhar, Kanra. And from Kanra to Kosh, there are so many proofs that my guru has shown. I am not going to show that today. If there is a seminar, I will say, because my guru has given me that knowledge. Now, this Ragang, we see that it is very much similar in the note combination. Ma Re is the basic. From here we have the resolution that Ma Re Sa, Ma Re Dha, Ma Re Ni was the first note when firstly the Shapta Shur or seven notes arises in the mind of human beings, illuminated human beings, Gandharvas. So Ma Re is very important in our Indian music. From this Ma Re, the first Ang had started Sarang. After that, in this Ma Re, when the half Gandha, the relation from Ma to Re, when coming, there arises Malhar. From that half Ga, when going up and down, gamma ray comes, kanra. And after, lastly, kosh, on a different manner. So, mare is very important, and all our music is very much scientific. To create a raga, it is not just a child's play. It has got so many specifications, like firstly, Purvang and Uttarang, Badi, Shambadi, and so on, different factors. The 10 properties of the swar notes. There are many things which the youngsters now do not think about it, but they must think about it when it is the question of traditional heritage music. Now this ang comes from here, and Purvang, there is a similarity between Purvang and Uttarang. Somebody who in Purvang, which is done in Uttarang, there will be a image of it. Like Mare, there will be Nipa. So this is the theory. This theory is totally Guru Mukhi. I will not say it because I can't say anything. I am not a guru. I am a follower of my guru, I think. But I had known something from that special person. Today I will start. My demonstration through kanra ang. Kanra I will play. In this kanra, there are 18 kanras. There are 18 kanras in our scriptures. And the original kanra is now extinguished. Nobody knows that what is the original kanra, because the original kanra was the whispers between the guru and disciple, and it can't be heard to anybody else. The kanra, so original kanra has been extinguished. Very few persons know it. My guru knew it. He has told me once. And Buddhadev Dasgupta, he is also demised. Pandit Buddhadev Dasgupta Sharad Priyar, he also knew. These great persons knew it, but in generally we have no idea upon what is that Shuddh Kanra. One day Tanshen asked, Emperor Akbar asked Tanshen in the Darbar to play Kanra. He wanted to listen Kanra. When he wanted to listen Kanra, Tanshen knew that it can't be produced in the Darbar. So he produced a type of kanra which can be played in the darbar, and it is called darbari kanra, and it became famous. Darbar ki kanra, mia ki kanra, that is Tanshen ki kanra, darbari kanra. And it is now the projection of kanra, that is darbari kanra. We know darbari kanra is kanra. No. Darbari kanra is not the real kanra. There are different kanras. I know some kanras also from my guru. First, today I will start with a kanra which is very rare, which have been developed by our big guru, that is Alauddin Baba. The rag is Bageshi Kanra. A very little I will tell now. Bageshi itself a raga. Bageshi is a very ancient raga. Bageshi. It can be termed in many ways. Goddess Swaraswati, we also called her Bageshwari. Bag, that is tiger, you can call it's the beauty of that tiger. You can call anything. It is from Kafi. There is lot of things to say, but I will shorten my discussion. I will go on my demonstration. Bageshi Kanra has been created, as per we know, by Alauddin Baba, and demonstrated by his guru like figures, Ali Akbar Khan, Annapurna Ji, and Ravi Shankar Ji. I had taken the talim of Bageshi Kanra from my guru. Something to tell. It has many persons use the Repa Swar Sangati here, Repa. But we don't use this, because Repa, Kafi, it denotes, it has the term, it denotes towards Kafi Kanra. For sharing, in Purvang, Darwari Kanra, in Uttarang, Bageshi. That is Bageshi Kanra. I will play the totally a khayal, my Guruji's khayal. I will speak in words also. The all compositions are made by my Guru Pandit Samaresh Chaudhary. He was a great composer also. He has composed 4,500 compositions in different ragas. So, this composition, first in Bilambit Ektal, that is Dinana ke tum nath, Dina bandhu, he prabhu kartar. First, I will sing this through my flute. I try to sing, but my voice is not so much good, and I have never practiced through my voice. I practiced through my flute, but I sing through my flute. It is my life's only what you can call also sadhana. I'm starting Bageshi Kanra. Please give the tab of Athanbras. Arecto. ताल दिए दे. आई एम स्टार्टिंग विथ द वर्ड्स. रे नयन के तुम thank you. তিনতাল 160 লং লুপ নাও ত্রিতাল বন্দিশ Thank you. think you had loved it. Now I will go to the AC director in Chris Kurva. AC. Now I will go towards 23 Kurva. Darwari Kanra. As you all know, this raga is a very favorite raga, mine also. Please, if possible, give your feedbacks. Pakar. Darwari Kanra. I'm starting.
Thank you.
Now I will play, I can play other bandishes also, but now I am playing Amir Khan, Ustad Amir Khan Tarana, Yare Man Biya Biya. I have been taught by my guru.
Thank you.
at a speed?
200.
Please give your feedbacks if you can.
टाइम कैसे
नाउ एट लास्ट आई हैड पेड माय ट्रिब्यूट टू ए माय एल्डर्स. लास्टली आई वांट टू offer my humble pranams to Bharat Ratna Pandit Bhimsen Joshi with his bhajan. Now the time is also very bad time running, so called bad time. From another aspect it is also good. The nature is purifying itself. All right, it is not our matter, but now ultimately the person who protects us, everybody knows, is Hari. हरीजी. तो मैं ये गाना के साथ हमारा ये डिमोंस्ट्रेशन को खत्म करूंगा. तुम बिन मोरे कौन खबर ले गोवर्धन गिरिधारी. आई एम ट्राइंग, इज वेरी टफ सॉन्ग. इन ट्रूथ इट इज सुपर टफ. But I will try. If any mistakes, please pardon me.
Make it ma and give pillow. Bhajan to tha, oi jijate chilo shekhane do.
আগের দিন সকালবেলা যেটা বলেছি,
thank you.
So I had played a lot and disturbed you, all of you. Please forgive my mistakes. But what I told, remember that love and the style of play with the pran, that is the love. It is the way. It must be the way. And if further I am given chance, there are many problem in this type of live programs are there, because it is not edited directly going, and I have no sound apps and something like that. But it is a discussion and a just what we will call it is a all of our own. So all right, hope you enjoyed, and if you want, you all want, I will again come to you and try to serve you, try to make you happy with my flute and music. Namaste. Namaste to all.